Hello, everyone, and welcome to this episode of Life with Zach, the channel where I explore my explorations and discoveries with you, the YouTube audience. Today, we're going to be talking about my newly purchased Yixin 511S drone. Now, if you want to check out my channel, you'll see that I have another video that came out last week talking about some of the first pictures and some of the first video clips that I did with this drone. Now, I've had it for about 2 weeks, so I'm still really kind of learning how to use it. So I'll be doing a full review probably in a week or so once I get a better handle on some of the different aspects and things about it. But what I wanted to do was do this video where I talk about contrasting the daytime photos and the daytime videos that I took with those kind of dusk, almost dark videos and photos that I took in the other video. Now, to start off with, what were the flying conditions that I was dealing with when I took the photos and videos that you're seeing kind of flashing before your eyes right now? So it was sunny. You can see that by the pictures. Very few clouds in the sky. And there was a light breeze. So you'll see that in some of the videos, the drone actually will move a little bit when it gets hit by the breeze. But actually, these were pretty close to ideal flying conditions. So when I saw it was that kind of day, I wanted to take advantage of it to really get the opportunity to test out this drone, really some of the first really good day photos and videos that I could get. Now, I did have the camera on its default setting. I haven't made any adjustments to it in terms of exposures or anything like that. And it is a 1080p camera. It's not the 720. So that's the kind of quality that we're getting. And all of these were saved to my phone, not to the micro SD card, which I haven't really even set up yet. So there is a little bit of quality loss in terms of the digital imagery being saved to my phone. Now, what are some of the things that I noticed when I was taking these photos and these videos with the drone? Number one, the photos are much clearer, of course, than they are at dusk. You'll see in the ones that are flashing by that it really, the light really makes a difference. I knew from the other week that this was not a low light level drone. It did not do very well in dusk conditions. And of course, the photos were much more improved. However, the sharpness, especially around the edges, it's still not 100% there on, you know, really compared to a really professional drone, and maybe even a little bit worse than what I was expecting when I initially got this. However, I still have to understand that this and most drone cameras are not the best quality. They're not even what you would get on your phone. They're not what you, and certainly not what you would get with a professional camera. Now, however, it does get the job done. These are not bad photos. They're just not the high quality that I do with a lot of other things. I will say that the camera did a great job when it was pointing down and the drone was stationary, okay? So, you know, even angled down a little bit, it does a great job with those top-down photographs. However, if you move the drone at all, or if the wind moves the drone at all, it really impacts the cameras and you'll get a lot of the jerkiness. You'll see this in some of the videos that I'm sharing kind of in the background. Really even the wind moving or the drone having trouble when hovering. So a couple of times the drone would have to make adjustments or I would have to make manual adjustments to level the drone so that it would hover better because there was a lot of jerking movement and stuff as it was trying to stabilize itself. So really any type of movement on this drone because it does not have a gimbal, okay, that would really stabilize the camera, any type of movement really messes with it and makes it really hard to get good quality video. So, you know, if you're going for photographs and stuff, that impacts it because you have to keep the drone very, very, very still to get a good photograph. Okay. And then three things really specifically I want to share in terms of the video, especially if trying to capture video while the drone is moving. Okay. So you remember I talked about how it jerks and all that. It actually doesn't do too bad of a job if you're moving the drone forward to backwards or backwards to forward. So if you're flying in a straight line, it doesn't do too bad as long as you keep it incredibly slow. You'll see in the clip where I where you see some of that, where I tried to speed it up, or I was speeding up and had to slow down, you see a lot of that jerking, a lot of that movement. If you can really feather it and move slowly going forward, going backwards, and keep it at a consistent speed, which I imagine I'll be able to do a little bit better as I get some more experience, the video doesn't turn out half bad. However, when the drone does move from side to side, okay, in terms of flying side to side, not moving the way the drone's pointing, you'll see that there's a lot more movement, because basically what happens is the drone kind of leans over and just starts moving. So you really lose a lot of that quality. But again, if you're moving forward and backwards, and even if you're pivoting, okay, if you're pivoting the drone the way it's pointing, you'll get pretty good video considering the drone that we're working with here. So again, I just wanted to share what some of these daylight photographs and video clips look like with the drone. I'm sharing them all unedited. I'd like to edit them for some other things, but you're seeing them unedited, what they came through my phone looking like. I was kind of impressed with what I came up with, especially after being a little bit worried in the low light setting when I first flew it at dusk, but it turned out pretty well. I mean, it's not 100% what I would like, but it is an $80 drone, so I'll take it for that price that I paid. So again, this was a review of the Isshin 511S drone with some daylight video and photograph. If you find value in this, be sure to hit like. I'd love to hear a comment with your experiences, what you have found out about this drone or other drones and you think that I should check out, and subscribe to my channel again as we explore really basically anything that I can discover through travel, through tech, through gadgets, through household appliances, and just through life in general, that I hope you will find useful. So again, if you find value in that, subscribe so that you can get those videos as they first come out. Thank you, and hope you have a wonderful day.